Hi, this is Tulika Saha from C4Craft. I'm going to teach how to decoupage a puzzle coaster set with tissue napkin. I'm using this 3-ply tissue napkin and place on the base to check the area which it will cover. So this part I will tear. First, I am painting it with gesso, which is a primer, to make the base workable. I applied primer both sides of the puzzle. Now I will sand to make it smooth. I'm using here semi-fine grain sandpaper. Now wipe the base properly to remove all dust. Now I'm using masking tape to fix all four parts together. Scotch tape works best for me as it doesn't peel the color or tissue napkin. Our base is ready. Though the base color of maximum tissue napkin is white, so here I am not applying any other color on primer. I am tearing the napkin with water and brush as I like the uneven edges so that it can be merged well with colors later. Take out all the plies of the napkin. Apply little amount of Mod Podge with flat brush and place only the upper part of the napkin on the portion you want. Dab in the middle first to paste it and then move towards edges. I use plastic wrap and a flat tool, but you can use old credit card too instead of this tool to make it wrinkle free. Dry properly and apply Mod Podge again to secure the tissue again. Then dry again. Now I am pasting a small part of the rest of the tissue to make a complete picture with the same process. I'm using semi-wet sponge first so that the sponge can absorb the extra glue. Dry thoroughly and then sand the edges. Now play with colors. I'm using the colors similar to this tissue napkin design colors. I'm using this stencil as it is matching well with the tissue design. March colors however you want. I did the back portion with rest tissue off camera as well. I use sponge dabber and brush both to merge colors. Now remove the masking tape carefully. Now cut it with paper knife as per the puzzle design very carefully. And sand all sides after that. I have sanded it off camera properly. I'm not satisfied with the blank green space below, so doing some sentiment stamping, but it's optional. I used archival ink so that it will not bleed with the glue or water. I did the same process at the back portion too. Still found something missing, so painting some grasses here and there. Trying to merge colors with the design, then dry thoroughly After that, apply varnish and it's done.